Find the sequence of similarity transformations that map ABC to DEF. Now ABC is clearly smaller than DEF, so there is a dilation involved here. And I'm just going to see if I can figure out what the scale factor has to be. AB is 3, and then DE is 6. So the dilation is 2. And the way you would write that is XY maps to 2X, 2Y. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and perform that dilation, and then we'll see what other transformations are needed. I like to do the dilation first. It just makes the process easier. Okay, so if we dilate A, which is 1, negative 3, to 2x, 2y, we just multiply each coordinate by 2. So 1 would become 2, and negative 3 would become negative 6. So that would be 2, and then negative 6 here off the graph. And I'm just going to put a little negative 6 here to remind me how far down we are. Now for point B, that's at 4, negative 3, and multiply by 2, and we'll get 8, negative 6. So that'll be over here at 8, and then down to negative 6. And now what I'm doing here is I'm kind of modeling a bad practice. It's not a good idea to go off the grid because then you really lose the precision of your drawing. Unfortunately, it's just the way this one worked out. But I'd recommend when you're drawing your own transformations, make sure you use a graphing grid that's big enough to contain all of them. Now let's look at C. That one is 3, negative 2. And that would go to 6, negative 4. So that's C prime. Okay, we'll go ahead, connect these. Okay. Now if you look at A prime, B prime, C prime, and DEF, it looks like those triangles are the same size now. It looks to me like we have a rotation here. And it looks like it's a 90 degrees counterclockwise. And the coordinate notation for that is XY goes to negative Y comma X. Okay, so if I apply that transformation to each of these, A prime will map to 6, 2. B prime will map to 6, 8. C prime will map to 4, 6. Okay, so this would be A prime. And B prime, 6, 8. That is way off the scale here. Once again, this is usually not a good idea. And then C prime would be up here, 4, 6. Okay, so now we change the size of the triangle, change the orientation of the triangle by rotating. Now it's just going to be a translation. So we're going to translate this triangle down to triangle DEF, well, down and over. And I'm really at a disadvantage now because two of these points are not on the grid, so I can't really just count and say what the transformation is. I have to rely on A prime to D. So A prime goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 to the left, And then 1, 2, 3, 4 down. So 7 to the left is x minus 7, and 4 down is y minus 4. Now let me try this just with c prime and see what happens. 7 to the left, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 4 down from there. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, it looks good. And I'm not really going to bother trying point B prime because, honestly, that's so far off the grid I can't justify counting here by the grid squares. But I'm fairly confident that these are the transformations. So we have this guy here, the dilation, scale factor of 2. And then we have these two guys, the 90-degree counterclockwise rotation and the translation 7 left and 4 down.